Good Wednesday. Hope y'all's week's going good. Just coming at y'all with a short video. Just want to get a few things off my mind and find out y'all's opinions. So the last few weeks now, I've been running into some customers that are all about, they find some other company that's going to do the job lower. They find this, that, and the third, or, you know, they start to question your pricing when you're doing jobs. And I guess my concern and my question to you all out there is, you know, when you make these new clients or consistent clients, you know, as years go by, and you first explain to them, you know, hey, you know, okay, these are the services you want. You want to be mowed, trimmed, blowed, you know, if you want your leaves and everything cleaned up during the fall, you know, you're giving them a square deal price, you know, all around, so nothing is, you know, out the blue. You know, everybody's on the same page, you know, from day one when you make your prices. So, my question to you all is, what's the deal, and how do you handle when people are like, well, you know, people who you've already explained this to, well, your prices are, you know, whatever, you know, I'm going to have to find somebody better. You knew in the beginning, you know, I told you, you know, this is why, you know, the price of what I'm charging you, this is why, you know, it is what it is. You know, I'm running a business here, you know, I understand that, you know, you feel that, you know, the price that I'm charging for my business may be too high. And of course, you know, everyone's going to look for somebody to do something a little bit, you know, less in price. But why is it, you know, you have to seem like explain this to certain people? It's not everyone. You know, you have those clients, they don't exchange anywhere with you. You tell them the price go up, get your payment however way you get your payment method, you get it, you know. But some, you know, they think, you know, when you do a mow, you know, that's your regular charge. But when they want you to do extra services like trimming trees or shrubs or hedges, you know, I guess they expect all of that is supposed to be the same price of your regular mowing service, and that's not the case. And my personal view on that is, you know, when I send you the updated statement, if you wanted me to do extra work, and I put in there specifically why, you know, the price went up some because, you know, I'm doing XYZ extra amount of work for you that you want it done, that you asked me to do. This is why I'm charging it, because, you know, this is my time. You know, this is my business. This is, you know, how I operate. And I'm doing, you know, a good service to you. You know, I just don't understand, you know, why mid-season some people try to throw that red flag up of the price. You know, everyone should know that across, you know, the country, prices of everything is going up. It's just not gas. But if you're running your own business, you know, things have to go up. I mean, shout out to the ones that can really, really afford this. You know, with the gas prices and everything going up the way it is, you know, that can just not even blink an eye when they put it to the gas tank. But for the ones of us, you know, that are out here that's doing this, and this is how you make your living, this is how you pay your bills, you know, this is how you keep food on the table, this is how you, you know, keep your vehicles going up and down the road, this is how you keep your equipment and everything in operation. operation just to do the job. Why does it seem like some people, you have to explain that to them in, you know, almost down to like baby terms, you know? And I understand, you know, everyone, like I say, is looking for the cheaper deal out, but I just don't get it. So how do y'all handle that? I mean, do y'all just eventually just, you know, if they don't tell you, you know, they don't no longer need your services, do y'all just part ways with them on your own? Do you service them one more time and say, you know, hey, this is going to be my last time servicing you? Or, I mean, it's one thing when, you know, you've made these, you know, agreements in the beginning, but when you're out servicing and your client is home, or they pull up while you're out servicing the yard, or, you know, someone is there that can, you know, ask some questions that they may be wanting to know, or better yet, they have your phone number, you know, why is it such a hard thing to reach out to the person that's doing stuff and say, hey, you know, can you explain to me, I know this happened, you know, 3 months ago, but, you know, can you explain to me again, you know, what's this, that, and the third? And that's easy to do. I mean, technology has came a very long way to where, you know, you can reach out and talk to anyone about anything, you know. That's just my question. And it sounds like a rant because it kind of is just like a repetitive thing. And I just, you know, reaching out to see what some of you veteran guys think about it. And like the last thing I want to say, I read something yesterday that said you have to be able to work without looking at the clock if you want to shop without looking at the price. And that makes a whole lot of sense. Meaning, you know, you got to put in some hard work out here, you know, if you want to continue to be able to live the lifestyle you live in. Some people don't have to live, you know, extravagant. Some people do this and, you know, this is all they need to do to get by. I mean, some people live simple lives. Some people don't have to go out and, you know, I guess, you know, splurge or keep up with the latest fashion trends or whatever, you know. And I'm one of those people. I'm a simple person. I don't have to go out here and keep up with the times. You know, I'm basic. You know, I don't go around just really trying to, you know, keep up with the Joneses. You know, I'm old school and I have my old soul. So I guess, you know, in a way, you know, doing what I do now, being in my second year full-time in my own business, I barely even look at the clock anymore. I really enjoy what I'm doing. And I know the amount of income I'm bringing in with this. You know, this isn't like a get-rich overnight. You know, this may be not even a get-rich-at-all type of, you know, path for someone. But, you know, living within your means and not trying to overdo your, you know, limits, you can do pretty good in entrepreneurship, you know, in lawn care or anything. But that was a good quote. You know, I saw that on an Instagram page. I can't remember the guy's name, but, you know, the old saying goes, you know, if you enjoy what you're doing for a living, you'll never work a day in your life. And a lot of people has found that in whatever entrepreneurship path they're going, whatever career field they're doing. And, you know, that's a great feeling when you do it, you know, when you reach that level. But, you know, there are the days when opposition comes in and it's like, come on now. You know, a lot of things can be solved with a conversation, a phone call, a text message, or a face-to-face. You know, as adults, I think everyone, you know, if you're really about your business, should be able to approach anybody that you're dealing with and, you know, have a discussion. Sit down, have a discussion, and figure things out. You know, but anyway, I just want to leave y'all with this video. Leave your comments below. Like, comment, and subscribe on this. I hope I get a lot of feedback and interactions on this, because, you know, it's just, you know, where do y'all draw the line at with certain things like this? You know, you have those customers, like I said earlier, you know, they don't even change a word with you. They tell you, you know, hey, I want you to do something extra. You tell them in return, hey, you know, that's going to be a little bit more to the price. They don't change words with you. You go and tell someone else that, you know, hey, you know, you want me to do extra work, that's going to be, you know, a little bit extra on top of what I'm already doing for you. Oh, well, why your price is this? Or I don't know if I'll be able to continue with you. Or I'm like, okay, well, you know, sir, ma'am, you know, whoever, you know, that's your right, that's your choice, but don't do that to someone in the middle of the season, you know, after you've already made agreements, you've already talked about things in the beginning. You know, in the beginning, your conversations with people, hey, you know, look, I know things have changed, I know the price of everything is going up, but I also have to act accordingly with my prices and my business as well. So, you know, this is how my season with you is going to operate. You know, rather if I'm going to increase my price with you with the regular services or not, that still doesn't mean that if you want additional services, that doesn't mean your fee is going to remain the same. It's going to go up. So anyway, leave your comments below. Like I say, let's interact really good on this. And let's get some good feedback. Hope everybody has a good rest of the week. It's Thursday. It's really hot down here in the South. So, you know, getting it done outside. You're sweating, so stay hydrated. You know, keep yourself in check when it comes to being out here in this heat. Don't let it fool you. But anyway, this is Simon from Grand Skidded Done Lawn Care. I hate to sound like, you know, a rant, but I just want to get that off my chest and see what some of you guys, you know, are saying. And to some of you new guys who are getting out here in this field, you know, pay attention to, you know, things that's being said in this video. And be mindful when you come across, you know, people like this. Anyway, y'all be safe out there. This is Simon from Grand Skidded Done Lawn Care. I'll see y'all in the next one.